I don't think it was the intentions to go to one bank and say we need to borrow $50 million whenever we was discussing these projects and doing local. I think the discussion came about at some of the public meetings that we'd talk to four or five banks and we'd have one lead bank out of that, out of those banks, to they'd pool their money and we'd give all the interest back locally to the banks here, which we think would be a lot cheaper than going with bonds. So as a recommending body, I'd be opposed to going with bonds because I think you'd spend a lot more money, plus it'd take a lot longer. And let's keep the money local with the local banks. I didn't have any authority, but over the period of the last 12 months, I've talked with several different banks, and that's what they would like to do. The investors would like to pool the bank's money and loan the county whatever money they need toward this. That was discussion that I had with some of them, and I think some of the board might be privy to that, but that was discussion that went on during the SPLOST referendum.
I will need to talk to them about how we're going to fund that.
One last thing about timing for bond issues. As far as when do we need to know as far as which way the path goes? Probably need about 2 to 3 months to get to go to market with a bond issue. That's how much time we need as far as working with the underwriters. Now, we're going through a refunding issue right now, so I don't know what's involved in doing that. So 2 to 3 months. We can probably do it in 2 months, but that just means if we think those interest rates, municipal bonds are going to be more favorable than if the primary groups or banks are not just offering us a low enough rate, if we think bonds are a better option. We need to make that decision when we're within about 2 to 3 months of needing some cash flow surplus. So that's our, and we're not there yet, so I think that we're sensitive that okay. Fork in the path, if you will.
There have been some discussion about banks, and I need to make a disclosure that I'm the vice chairman of the board of the Citizens Bank of Forsyth County. And if that bank is included in any of these discussions, I would have to disqualify myself from any voting or consideration because that would be a conflict of interest.
Mm-hmm. Thank
so
you,
I
sir.
Want to make that formal disclosure.
I'd like to make a disclosure too that my wife serves on the board with Jeff, Captain Amos. So I would also too, if their name came up, I would have to accuse myself from any discussion with that bank or vote.
Okay. So noted. So without exception, is that the direction the committee wants to go, is to have today run some numbers and bring it back to the next meeting?
Yeah, and have some discussion with some banks.
Yeah, if anyone's familiar with any local banks you think are interested, please let me know, because we'll talk to all of them. And I think that there's been interest from what I'm going to say about working with local financing. We've never really defined that. At this point, I think I recommend those that have a presence in the county one way or another, and some are larger institutions, some are they need to be large enough to handle this kind of transaction as well. Sometimes there's a consortium of banks that work together. So have some kind of presence in the county, or if it's been a bond underwriter we've worked with before, that would at least narrow who we work with down to those. But otherwise, we're already getting people from outside the area contacting us about they want to do bond issues and other things. So.
Would it be then the desire of this committee to identify what this committee believes and then make that recommendation board what a local bank is, or leave that to the Board of Commissioners once we get to that point?
Certainly if their headquarters here in their base, or maybe more roots of being local,
that one's obvious.
Been just having a branch or two here.
Well, we don't have a lot of them as headquartered here. We have the smaller banks as headquartered here in the Cumming. We don't have a lot of them that is the big banks, but the four or five that I've talked to are the smaller banks who wanted to come together as a group and have one lead bank and all of them pool their money, and that one lead bank to be the one that would deal with you on your draw. So if you wanted 50 million, 25 million, or whatever, they could come up with that as a pool.
Yeah, as long as the numbers work, I agree with that. If you want to keep your money local, then you can.
We can furnish some names to you, Dave.
So no action from this committee with respect to what a local bank is?
I don't think we need to go there. But
okay.
The fact of the matter is we don't have but a two or three little small local banks. I think we just need to give them names. You know, we know the banks here in the area, and we want to be sure the banks are coming for South County Bank that they operate here.
For clarification, not just a branch, but the
main
offices here.
The main offices here?
Office here. Yeah.
Okay. Is been this committee's desire to just have Mr. Gruen talk to those banks?
I couldn't give you the name of all the banks that would be there, so I don't know which banks they are.
Okay.
Why don't we consider this? Mr. Gruen will get with all the banks that are local, have their main headquarters here, and see if they can pull it together. If they can't, then he'll secondly have to go look at the next level of tier out, when they have a lot of branches here, employees here, and also look into your bonding sources that we've used in the past.
Gotcha.
I guess that takes the question that we've had. Once again, I agree with concept. How do we define a local bank?
I think because the branch that have headquarters that can be here.
We got some that I would presume that maybe we have some that have quite a lot of branches here, do business here, but their main office might be in just across the county line in another county. But yet they are not one of the big, you know, national banks that just have branches here. So we're back to trying to establish what's the criteria to define.
I guess we're talking about local banks. We're talking about banks that are located here in the area where they, where the headquarters out of Charlotte, where they say headquarters out of Florida.
Would you prefer the headquarters are in Georgia first, if that's at all possible, to keep some of the main funds local?
That might be that may be one way to start drawing it down. They're headquartered in Georgia. Yeah. They're chartered in Georgia, I guess.
That would help a lot, probably.
With branches here.
With branches. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Without exception?
Abstain. And by the way, Mr. Chairman, I've got a jury waiting on me.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Judge.
My lead. Thank
appreciate
you,
sir. It. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay.
I think we have a strong committee here, and I'm looking forward to getting this project started as soon as possible. Make tremendous value to our county and the city.
Looks like I've been here all day. I hope so.
So, Mr. Chairman, the only other item on the agenda is review funding options. Is that correct?
That's correct.
And I'm disqualified from that. I think I mentioned last time that serving on the board of the Citizens Bank in Forsyth County, I am absolutely disqualified from that discussion. Plus, I've got a jury waiting on me to get started back. So I will take my leave. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Your Honor.
All right, we're back to item two, review funding options. Additional discussion.
I have one more thing. Sure. Good question the mayor brought up about interest rates and bank loans. I'll give you a little bit of what I've seen, a little bit market wise, a little bit of what the banks have talked about. Remember, a fixed rate is going to be for 5 years, it's going to be at least at 2.6%. It could be higher. If we were to go right and say, give us a quote for a 5 year loan. Variable rates are lower, and they're probably going to be in the range of 2.1-2.2%, somewhere around there, from what we're starting to see from some of the banks. Think about variable rates, and they may stay flat for right now in the market. It's at least 2 years, but you know, world economy, I'm not going to make any bets in interest rates myself. The fact that they're variable is just there's a component of risk to that and cost, especially since the repayment's going to be a little bit more back-end loaded. So that gives you a little bit more of an idea of interest rate cost with banks. Variable rate right now, you can probably get low twos, 2.1%. Fixed rate for 5 years is going to be above, I think 2.6 is probably pretty close to where I think the market is now. The only other thing to consider there, and we could also do a variable rate bond, and that would be much lower than 1.3% now.
Too much risk.
Change.
Too much risk.
And too much risk. And the thing where I can see that risk, others are sensitive to it. In our discussion with the rating agencies, particularly S&P, they were really drilling us on questions about, we only have one variable rate bond out there right now. And when they were doing our rating, their double A-plus rating, I think we might get AAA, that made them very nervous to have a variable rate issue out there, and under what scenarios could it be called in and so on. So, you know, variable rate is tempting because it's so low, but I think fixed rates are likewise as low as you're ever going to see them pretty much right now. So that just add a little bit to the discussion of interest rates and risk.
Dave, one question. When do you think we'll know if we need a 30 or 40 or 50 million? I mean, what's our time frame on this?
I think as we have an idea when we'll have an architect on board, because then they're going to start doing work and we're going to start eating cash. That will give us a much better idea of maybe which month toward the end of this year. I think it's going to be before January 1, we'll probably need some funding, but I'm not sure how close to July at this point. But, and there's one other thing involved here with the county, Commissioner Levent was pointing out, that may affect the amount, is what about other projects and road projects and, you know, engineering and so on. So the commission maybe have some concern there, and that could affect the amount we borrow for the jail and courthouse, but it affects how much of the other dollars are available for other projects. So
they do 1, 2, 3, 4 streets per neighborhood around the whole county every year just to try to keep up with the road improvements. And I hate to see them shut those down for 3 or 4 years and then us try to catch up. It'd be very hard on them.
On the bond, I favor the banks, but this is the reason. If you do a bond and say you got to have $40 million, you do a bond for $40 million. You start paying interest on it.
Right.
On the banks, you pay interest on what you borrow right. at that particular day. If you borrow $1 million, if you have a pay request, I think you can expedite the project a lot faster by doing it through local banks and have one bank who is going to work with all the local banks, and they got their pool of ever how much money the board votes they need down the road, whether it's 30 million, 40 million, or whatever, which I think it'll be somewhat less probably because another year the SPLOST 7 revenue is going to be coming in, and as Chairman alluded to, you've got maybe 8% over what it was last year right now, and you say it could be as much as 4% throughout the year. So if we're going to be taking in the revenue, we don't want to be. I think logic would be that you'd use that revenue to pay down the loan, and you won't be penalized due to the fact this local banks rather than a bonding company. So that's my theory.
I would agree with you, Mayor. In addition to that, you want to borrow right away, so you'll save interest on it.
But, and I did take that timing into consideration of this 2 million versus 2.5 million interest. I did take into consideration the bond issue all at once and drawing the banks down. So even though this bank rate of 2.6% is twice 1.3%, you notice the cost is not twice as much because I've calculated in only paying interest on when we draw the money.
What kind of time frame do we need to deal with banks or bonding companies? Do we need to start 2 months before we need the money, or 30 days, or that could be critical.
I mean, the bank is ready once they do their credit checks, and some of them banks are already working on this, and they're virtually ready to go themselves. The time constraint there is getting all the legal documents in place. The lawyers still have to work on the documents, the bank's lawyers, our counsel, it'll be just as binding as a bond issue. I mean, it'll be that secure for the banks as a bond issue, as a bondholder would be. So as fast as the attorneys can get all the paperwork, so I'm thinking probably within 30 days would be my guess on that.
If we use the $40 million, if we bond it, if we went for a bond for $40 million, and then at the end of the day, we only use $30 million, that additional $10 million could not be redirected to other projects because of the, as I understand, the wording in the referendum, it's still going to be locked in correct. To this project.
Correct.
Whether we needed it or not.
Well, as money comes in, you don't have to throw it in the jail courthouse and you can't use that for the other projects.
That is another point. You're right. I mean, that with that cushion, then other monies from the SPLOST could be redirected to the other projects.
Mm-hmm. And all of our other departments won't be able to keep up with their duties and not get so far behind.
Right.
If we borrow $40 million, these projects, 2 projects are $100 million, so they will be first dollar. We will, I think, whatever we borrow is going to be considered going to the jail courthouse.
Sure.
It just leaves some of the sales tax collections available for them.
And then on the other hand, these bond funding options and the bank loan options are really moving targets because under the bond funding, you've got options there that don't compare with banks because the banks may be paid back quicker than you'll pay the bonds back.
Well, only up to $14 to $15 million per year because a referendum restricts our ability to do that.
But say for instance you wanted to do that in the bank, you could do that where you're not legally bind to do that with bonds.
Right, right. You have more flexibility with the bank loan as to how much you borrow and when you pay it back. Right. Bond is a fixed issue, although you can have call provision in a bond, which means you can pay it back earlier. But if you have a call provision,
a penalty,
that pushes the interest rate up.
It's a penalty.
There's a premium for that.
Is this some decision we need to make today?
I think I'm just reporting based on the committee's interest.
You know, I don't really think that we don't have to make a decision unless
right.
We have a more there's still this uncertainty about the exact amount of money we're talking about here, but understanding what our options are.
What I convey to the banks is we're trying to be in a position where that's where we want to go. The board commission wants to say that we're ready to go with them.
So sure.
And then we have selected a group that's interested.
Well, to save you time and energy, does this board need to vote whether we want to go bonds or banks? I don't know if the board couldn't go ahead and decide to say.
I wouldn't recommend that at this point, since the cost could vary on which vehicle you use, depending on how much and when. I don't know if we're to that point. I wouldn't recommend making that decision at this point myself.
Would it make sense to get the program manager on board? Let him and his staff work on cash flow analysis for us, and then we'll know what that amount might be. At that point, we could reconvene, talk about this issue again, and then make a recommendation to the Board of Commissioners.
We've only been working off of one schedule. That schedule of how fast or how slow it takes to build these things can shift dramatically. There goes millions of dollars in their construction schedule. So
and
that's
help, important. Help this group with this, if in fact we follow that timeline, but we need some funding on the front end to pay for the project manager and maybe even the architect, we've got funding elsewhere that we can use until we cure this funding for the project.
Yes, and we fronted some money to buy the properties and so on. So.
What kind of time frame would that be? 2-3 months out, so if you're thinking about revisit this again?
Really, I don't know if we get the program manager.
I'm saying, what do you anticipate?
The RFP closes on the 24th of May.
Right.
And so after that, it's the selection process. And it really, I hate to put a timeline on the selection process, it really depends on how many we get.
Right.
I have had 36 firms pick up, and I took out the ones that I know aren't firms. 36 firms have picked up the proposal. So I'm not going to get 36 responses, I don't believe.
2 to 4 months?
Once we get them, we have our initial kickoff meeting on the 30th of this month of May. I would say at least a 4-week period before we take it to this board and then to the Board of Commissioners for review.
Okay, so then they have to have time to put their numbers together.
Exactly.
So you could be 4 months out.
Yeah, they'll need some time to get on board and look at the program.
Very good. Just trying to get an idea.
Right.
Sure.
Any other discussion on that item? No action on that item at this time. Dave, anything else?
No, we'll keep monitoring market conditions and we'll get the ideas in from the banks as what kind of vehicles they think they could offer.
Right. Thank you. That is the last item on the agenda unless there's further discussion. One thing I do want to mention is even though we didn't send out invitations, I think the first time around we had mentioned you are more than welcome to bring your support staff. And that's just an open invitation. If you've got support staff that you would like to have at these meetings, you're welcome to invite them on your own. We don't want to assume that to invite them that you want us to invite them, or we assume who those folks are. So any support staff you'd like to have at these meetings, please invite them.
Commissioners don't get support staff, sir. I think you're talking to me.
I am your support staff.
He's here.
Do I hear any other business before the board? For this team?